Something to talk about.
Give me something to talk about.
High school stories, scandals, pranks, and controversies.
Boredom and being in high school are a very dangerous combination. Check out what happens when a teenage boy wonder gains access to every printer in his school and opens up his own personal printing press.
This is Rineyville, Kentucky, a very small farming town outside of Louisville. That's not exactly action-packed.
It's just a volunteer fire department and a gas station.
The post office probably isn't as big as my kitchen is, and that's about it.
Rineyville isn't the ideal chill spot for most teenagers, but thanks in part to its state-of-the-art technology, the local high school is.
The technology department in the school is one of the best.
They do have a couple computer labs in the school, and then in the library there's another 20 computers or so.
That's Matt. Most folks around these parts know him as the quiet type. But from a young age, he could make some noise on the keyboard.
He could work the computer long before he could talk.
He's basically like Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde. Well, he's shy, mellow, keeps to himself, but he sits there at home and hacks away at people's computers.
He looks just like this normal kid, but underneath this exterior, there's this menacing super genius.
As a junior at Hardin High, Matt's mad skills on the CPU were quite a commodity in a computer class where anything went.
I set up this chat room on my website so we all can talk to each other through class. All right.
It's the messenger. It's not supposed to work at school, so he created a chat room that everybody could talk on.
You could chat from different computers without anyone knowing, and they would just chat back and forth all the time.
But chatting wasn't enough for this renegade, so he went typing for trouble, and it wasn't long before he found it.
I came across a server on the network. It had about 50 different printers located in it. Well, when I saw this, I was like, did I really find this? This is gonna be real cool.
Dylan, Ricky.
He starts explaining to me, he could type anything on his computer, send it to any printer within the school, they wouldn't know where it came from, so it was phantom printing.
Oh, man.
We thought, why don't we use the school system against them, basically make their lives chaos.
Teacher.
The next day, Mad Matt called a meeting of the minds in the lunchroom to strategize.
So I was like, we need to find some stuff to print. What do you guys want to print off?
Dude, I got an idea. Check out this guy's mullet.
We were going to make up a bunch of random slogans.
Fear the mullet.
We gotta make it look like hackerish.
What are you talking? Okay.
PH. Look at that. Fear.
Fear.
The mullet.
JR, you got any ideas?
Kid eats a lot of cookies, so why not just go with the cookie gang?
Alright, the cookie gang has struck again.
I was just thinking, man, this is gonna be awesome.
With their plan in place, the guys headed to the computer class where they would premiere their printing prank.
Matt assumes his normal post.
We put Fear the Mullet, selected the printer we wanted, 20 copies. And we hit file print.
Okay, everybody, email me yesterday's homework assignment, please.
I was in another class, and pages start printing out of nowhere.
Who's printing this?
And my teacher, she's yelling, stop, stop.
Stop printing. Who is printing this? I am not playing.
Everybody in the hallway was like asking about it.
The teacher was going crazy.
They saw papers.
Yeah.
Over the next week, Matt sent hundreds of print jobs with snappy slogans all over the school, creating major confusion.
We did 5 to 7 printers, between 100 and 600 copies.
What is this?
Just kept printing out copies and probably wasted so much ink.
Hearing everybody talk about our work, it just made us feel powerful.
With confidence on the rise, the printing posse went for the ultimate prize.
The principal's definitely a little bit too uptight.
I typed in, juniors and seniors own you, 2K4.
You see the number change from 1 to 10 to 100 to 500.
And I hit print 500 times to the principal's office.
Oh my God, how many are there?
Juniors and seniors own you, what's this?
Juniors.
Oh my gosh.
The office staff was going crazy.
What's going on?
I don't know what it is.
Can we stop this?
Look
Oh, why can't you turn the printer off?
Call IT and have them see if they can stop this stuff.
It was basically chaos for the staff. We were enjoying it.
At that point, the administration went on an all-out hacker hunt, determined to find the source of the paper trail.
They came up and searched the computer to see if I'd printed anything from it.
It's not his computer.
I got to Matt's chat room and sent him a message telling him that I was searching rooms for the printers.
About 5 minutes later, I was actually escorted down by our cop. I was kind of worried because usually I don't get in trouble, like, from the school.
Matt, I just want to know if you know anything about all this computer deal that's going on.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, we're pretty sure it's coming from the fourth block class. And when we look at fourth block, you're really the only one who's capable and knowledgeable doing this stuff.
Nah, I wouldn't say that. There's a lot of smart people in the school. I was like, I heard about this happening, but it wasn't me.
Okay, you better get on back to class now. Don't be surprised if I call you back now.
I was 100% sure that they cannot catch me. I knew they might question me, but I knew they cannot prove it.
Over the weekend, Matt laid low, hoping things would die down. But Monday morning, it was deja vu as security gave him another personal escort.
All right, Matt, I'm a busy man and I'm getting really tired of this cat and mouse game. If you'll just tell me what you know about all this and confess, it'll go a lot easier on you. The IT guys have done some checking and we know all about the chat room.
He was in my chat room apparently monitoring it, and he found some stuff that linked me to the printers. Maybe I printed a couple dozen.
A couple dozen? 3,000 is not a couple dozen, Matt.
All right, so I did it.
You're suspended for the rest of the day. On top of that, you're gonna pay us back for all the resources we spent. You're gonna go to Saturday school, and you're banned from the school's computers for a year.
All right. That's when it hit me hard. I was pretty bummed out that I didn't get to use them no more. Like, taking a computer away from me is like taking a basketball away from Michael Jordan.
Matt felt bad about what he'd done. So when the administration demanded that he reveal the flaws in the school system, he readily agreed.
Yeah, there you go. I told the computer administrator how to fix it. And guess what? It's still not fixed. So that means another phantom printer could appear at any time.